4.2 टू स विथ लव पार्ट 6। हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन माय लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर आई एक्सप्लेन्ड यू हाउ द स्टूडेंट्स रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स फ्रॉम द नरेटर रिकी ब्रेथवेट्स क्लास reported on different subjects in the half yearly report of the Students Council of Greenslade School. In the end of my last video lecture, we read that Fun Man, one of the students representative from the narrator's class, was going to report about the subject physiology. As usual, he had a trump card. Up his sleeve. When he was called to present his report, he made signal to someone off stage. And Welsh and Allison, other students, appeared carrying the skeleton with a sort of gallows. Friends, we read this extract or chapter 17 till this part. Now, let's turn towards the next part of this chapter 17 of the novel To Sir With Love. So friends, open your textbook of English and see on page number 183. See on page number 183, the last paragraph. At the left side, on page number 183, the last paragraph at the left side. I will read it and explain you. This last paragraph at the left side. When this arrangement had been set up, there was the skeleton hanging from a hook screwed into the top of its skull, gently revolving at the end of a cord. And when these arrangements were made by Fun Man, who was presenting his report on the subject of physiology, there was a skeleton hanging from a hook screwed into top of its skull, gently revolving at the end of a cord. That skeleton was gently revolving at the end of its cord. This was somewhat in the nature of comic relief, and the school showed its approval by laughing uproariously. And moreover, this was somewhat bringing the skeleton there at the stage for presenting the report on the subject of physiology by Fun Man. was somewhat in the nature of comic relief in that event, and the school showed its approval by laughing uproariously. Uproariously means in an extremely noisy and confused way. And the school showed its laughing, or school showed its approval by laughing in an extremely noisy and confused way. So bringing of that skeleton in that school event of presenting the report by fun man was somewhat in the nature of comic relief in that event. And the school showed its approval by laughing in an extremely noisy and confused way. But levity soon evaporated when Fun Man began to speak. His voice was clear and precise, and he had a very strong sense of dramatic, you say, the writer tells us that. But levity means here the treatment of a serious matter with humor. But levity soon evaporated when Fun Man began to speak. His voice was clear and precise, and he had a strong sense of the dramatic element, or the dramatic. Calmly, he told them that it was a female skeleton. That was a fact and could easily be proved. Very soon, the humorous treatment of that serious matter, just because of bringing that skeleton in that event, was evaporated, was abolished, was evaporated, was decreased when Fun Man began to speak, and his voice was clear and precise, and he had a strong sense of dramatic element. Calmly he told them that it was a female skeleton, and that was a fact and could easily be proved. Calmly Fun Man told them that it was a female skeleton. It was the skeleton of a female. It was a skeleton of a woman. That was a fact. And that was the fact that skeleton was of a female. And it could be proved easily. But he could not say with any assurance whether she had been Chinese or French or German or Greek. Nor could he say if she had been brown or white or a mixture of both. Then Fun Man told them that it could be easily understood that this skeleton is of a woman, this skeleton is of a female. But he could not say with any assurance whether this skeleton is of a woman, is of a Chinese woman, or of a French woman, or of a German woman, or of a Greek woman. Even he also could not say whether she had been a brown or white or a mixture of both. And from that, he said the class had concluded that basically all people were the same. The trimmings might be different, but the foundations were all laid according to the same blueprint. Now see here, trimmings. Trimmings means superficial things. Trimmings means superficial things or things that are not very important. Trimmings means superficial things or the things which are not very important. Blueprint. Blueprint means here master plan. Master plan. And as Feynman told them that he cannot prove, we can easily prove and recognize that this skeleton is of a woman, is of a female. But he said that he could not prove whether that skeleton is of a Chinese female or a Chinese woman or a French woman or a German woman or a Greek woman. And even he could not say that whether she had been a brown woman or a white or a mixture of both. And from that, he said, from that fact, their class learned that basically all people were the same. And from this fact, he said, Feynman told them that from this fact, their class learned that basically all human beings, all people are the same. Only the trimmings might be different. Only the superficial things might be different. But the foundations which are inside the skeleton, which are there in every human beings, are the same according to the master plan in all human beings. Feynman was wonderful. He had them eating out of his hand. Miss Dare's contribution was something of an anticlimax after Feynman's performance, and she seemed to realize it. Feynman was wonderful. He had them eating out of his hand. The performance of Feynman in presenting the report of his subject was wonderful. Miss Dare's contribution. Now, Miss Dare was another student who was also presenting physiology along with Feynman. Miss Dare's contribution was something of an anticlimax after Feynman's performance, and she seemed to realize it. And after Feynman's performance, after Feynman's presentation of report of physiology, Miss Dare's contribution was something like an anticlimax. She spoke about the problems which all humanity has to face in terms of sickness and disease, and of the advantages gained by interchange of knowledge, advice and assistance. This Miss Dare, who was presenting the report of the subject physiology along with Feynman, spoke about the problems which all human beings are facing or they have to face in terms of sickness and disease, and of the advantages gained by interchange of knowledge, advice and assistance. Means she is expressing her views that she learned from physiology, she learned, and the students and their class learned about the problems which all human beings are facing regarding the sickness and diseases. And she also explained that the advantages can also be gained. Regarding this, the advantages can also be gained by interchange of knowledge, advice and assistance of human beings to each other. Miss Dodd reported on the period of history. See, Miss Dodd is another student representative from the narrator's class. Miss Dodd reported on the period of history. The class had studied the Reformation in England. Another student representative from the narrator's class was presenting the report on history. Expressed her views on the period of history that their class had studied, and that period of history was the Reformation period in England. She told of the struggles of men of independent spirit against clerical domination and of their efforts to break from established religious traditions. Clerical domination. See the word clerical domination. Clerical domination means here domination by extremely religious people like priests. Domination by extremely religious people like priests. She told of the struggles of men of independent spirit against the domination of the religious people like priests, and the efforts of these independent minded people to break that established religious traditions. From those early beginnings, gradually grew the idea of tolerance for the beliefs and cultures of others, and the now common interest in trying to study and understand those cultures. And from those early beginnings, slowly the idea of tolerance grew for other beliefs and faiths of other people and other religions. From those early beginnings, the idea of tolerance for the beliefs, for the principles and theories of other religions and other cultures of other people grew slowly. And now the common interest in trying to study and understand those cultures, and now to study those cultures of others, those religions of others, have become the matter of common interest for people. This Miss Dodd spoke and told that now, just from those early beginnings till today, till now, this idea of tolerance for the beliefs of other religions and other cultures of other people slowly grew, and the people are finding the common interest, or there is a common interest in people in trying to study and understand the cultures of other people, the principles and beliefs of other people and other religions too. Denham's report was a bit of a shock. Denham, another student representative of the narrator's class. Denham's report was a bit of a shock. He severely criticized the general pattern of PT and games, emphasizing the serious limitations of space obtaining and the effect of that limitation on their games activities. Denham's report was a bit of shock. He severely criticized the general pattern of the subject PT, physical training, and games, emphasizing the serious limitations of space and the effect of that limitation on their games activities. He presented the serious matter. He criticized the general pattern of physical trainings and games, highlighting or emphasizing the serious limitations of space and the effect of that limitation of space was there on the activities of the games. He complained that the PT was ill-conceived and pointless and the routine monotonous. He could see no advantage in doing it. A jolly good game was far better. Ill-conceived. Ill-conceived means badly planned or and unwise. Badly planned and unwise. Pointless. Pointless means having no purpose and hence waste of time. Pointless means having no purpose and hence waste of time. Or in simple words, pointless means here waste of time. And ill-conceived means here badly planned. He complained, or Denham complained, that the subject PT was badly planned and it was just a waste of time. And the routine of that subject was also boring. He could see no advantage in doing it. Instead of this, a jolly good game was far better than this subject of PT. Apparently, he was voicing the opinions of all the boys, for they cheered him loudly. And apparently, this Denham was voicing, he was expressing the opinions of other all boys, for they cheered him loudly. Means here Denham was expressing the opinions of all other boys, and because of that all the boys were cheering him loudly. When the reports were over, Denham called two children at random from the audience and asked them to write the name of each teacher, including the head, on a slip of paper. And when the reports were over, Denham called two children at random from the audience and asked them to write the name of each teacher, including the head, on a slip of paper. So friends, we should stop here. In my next video lecture, I will explain you the next part of this lesson. I hope you are reading this text or this extract again and again, so that you will really enjoy and learn what is novel and how it is to be understood properly. So friends, I rest here. Thank you so much. हैव अ नाइस डे।